Joining us now is Dr. Peter Hotez, co-director of the Center for Vaccine Development at Texas Children's Hospital and dean of the National School of Tropical Medicine at Baylor College of Medicine. Dr. Hotez, welcome to the show. Happy New Year. There is some debate over the role that COVID is playing in the kids' hospital admission. CDC Director Rochelle Walensky somewhat downplayed the situation last week, saying many children are hospitalized with COVID as opposed to because of COVID. Can you explain what's going on here and whether that's a meaningful distinction?
Yeah, you know, Mehdi, we got a hint of this from South Africa, where we saw lots of pediatric hospitalizations. But, you know, some clearly were being admitted with signs and symptoms of COVID, shortness of breath or coughing, respiratory symptoms, et cetera. But others were picked up just on when they were hospitalized for other reasons and were found to be positive because they were testing all kids who came into the hospital. So I think we're seeing a mixture of both. What's happening, I think, is Omicron is not targeting kids selectively. It's just so highly transmissible that this is creating a firestorm or a blizzard of virus, and that's causing a lot of kids to get infected, and therefore they're being hospitalized as well. So this was anticipated, and we saw it a little bit with Delta in the South and here in Texas over the summer, but now it's even amplified because Omicron is even more transmissible than this.
So, Dr. Hotez, if you're a parent whose kids are about to go back to school on Monday, how concerned should you be about your kids picking up the virus, especially if they're not fully vaccinated yet, not boosted? We're hearing there may be boosters for 12 to 15-year-olds next week. And how worried should you be about them bringing it home to you?
Well, it really depends. It really very much depends on where you are. I mean, no question in New York City and Washington, D.C., this epidemic is really raging and there's a lot of transmission. And I advise to hold off for a week or two until we get on the downside of this. But I think the best thing you can do right now is to max out your vaccination. So right now, nationally, with five and up, we're underperforming terribly. I think only about 15-20% of the kids that age have been vaccinated. So we've got to improve on that. And we also, as you point out, now we have the opportunity to boost the teenagers with the Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine. I think that's great. But again, you know, here in the South, the vaccination rates of the 12 to 17-year-olds are only half what they are in the North. So that's where we have to push really hard, in addition to doing everything possible to keep our schools safe.
And just on the youngest age group, under five-year-old kids who can't get vaccinated yet, are we close to having a dosage amount that works for those children? Because I believe that's been an obstacle so far.
Yeah, I think there's been some issues with immunogenicity showing that the vaccines in that young age group can induce a protective immunity. So that may be a limitation of the mRNA technology, but they might find ways to improve it on it as well. So I think it will get sorted out, but it won't happen right away, maybe later on in 2022, at least here in the U.S.
Dr. Hotez, your vaccine was just approved for use in India, the vaccine that you guys in Texas worked on. Congratulations on that achievement, on that accomplishment. Talk to us about what that means, why it matters on a global scale.
Well, you know, what we've seen, other than the obvious humanitarian urgency to vaccinate the world, is the simple fact that Delta arose out of an unvaccinated population in India and Omicron arose out of an unvaccinated population in Southern Africa. Until we vaccinate the global South, Africa, Latin America, and Southeast Asia, we're going to have devastating variants come all over the world, and no one really seems to be stepping up to try to make that happen at a meaningful level. So hopefully our vaccine, which is easy to scale, simple to administer, great safety profile, now has been released for emergency use authorization in India. They have a biological E, our industrial partner, an extraordinary group, has 150 million doses ready now, and they're going to start vaccinating with another 100 million doses a month, up to 1.2 billion. And now we've licensed our technology again with no patent or strings attached to Indonesia, to Bangladesh, to now to an organization in Botswana. And hopefully this will start filling the gap.
That is fantastic news. Dr. Hotez, a special thanks to you for coming on this morning and giving us some very good news as we start 2022. Appreciate it. Happy New Year.